happens, and people deliver things or people don't deliver things. People leave you hanging. People leave you kind of wondering what the heck is going on in their mind, and you still have to keep going. So you cannot rest on your laurels. You cannot stay wondering what, why are they not responding to me? Why have they just let me go? Why are they just not answering my questions? Why are we not moving forward together? And at some point, you just have to say enough's enough. And you move forward, and you have to keep moving forward, because no matter what, you still have to deal with you, your personal life, your personal goals, yourself. And you still have to look yourself in the mirror. And you don't want to get to the point of, man, I wasted a whole year waiting for that. And again, it doesn't have to be that way. What it does have to be is that you decide, you know what? It's going to get better. It's going to get better. It has to get better. You have to keep moving, growing, going forward, and ensuring that no matter what, you don't take two steps back because you took one step forward. And once you've made your decisions, and once you've set your goals, and once you set your vision, your mission, and you've set yourself up for success, then you have got to do everything you can to make a success. And even if it means cutting people out of your life, whether they like it or not, you still have to do what is right for you. So don't worry about cutting people out of your life. You know, it doesn't matter at what level they are. You know, somebody you knew a while back, somebody you've known all your life, or somebody you just met, and then all of a sudden, boom, it turns around that basically they weren't the right person for you. They were not the right person for you. Not you right for them. They were not right for you. And you've got to understand that you've got to put yourself at the top of this pillar. You've got to put yourself at the top. And that's the only way you're going to succeed, because if you don't put yourself at the top and you're constantly, constantly giving in to others, then you know what? What's the point? So that's why goal setting, you write down your goals, you put your goals down on paper, and you figure out, hey, it's going to take this long. You figure out what you need to do to achieve it. You do a little backward planning. And throughout all of that, what should permeate is that you're hanging around people that are going to get you to where you need to be. And I'm not talking about kissing ass, and I'm not talking about schmoozing. I'm not talking about working the room. What I'm talking about is hanging around like-minded people. If people want to be successful in real estate, then you find those people that want to be successful in real estate. Because folks, those that are successful in real estate, guess what? They want to stay successful, and they're not going to bring you up because it's more competition for them. And why is it competition in real estate? Because if nobody's ever told you, it's this simple. They're not making any more dirt. That's it. The earth is not creating any more new land. Sure, you got a volcano or two out on Hawaii and in South America or along the Ring of Fire. But again, that's not going to be land. It's going to be livable for about another 10,000 years. Okay. And even then, it's still creating more. So what I'm saying is that's where the competition is those that are in real estate that want to make it. Well, guess what? I mean, that are already making it. They're not going to want the competition. That's why you hang around with people who are going to make it happen, who are wanting to make it happen, or on the path of making it happen. Because again, they realize that they become the sum of the people they hang around with. They become who they hang out with. And if they hang out with positive people and people with a focused mindset, mindset of abundance and growth, then guess what? They start growing. They start seeing that there's abundance, and they start seeing that, hey, there's enough for everybody. Now, those that have made it, yes, there's some people like that. And maybe I went a little too far and skewed that. But not everybody's that way. Not everybody's that way. And that's fine. That's fine. But that's when you realize who has the abundance mindset and who doesn't. Who is in it for themselves and who's in it for everybody. Who's in it to succeed as a collective, as a group, and who's in it just to, you know what, bring others down. And when you're bringing others down, you know, nobody wants to be around that, because that negative thought, that negative way of living is not beneficial to anybody. That negativity sucks. And it sucks because it sucks the life out of you trying to move forward, trying to grow, trying to succeed. And it sucks the life out of them because, again, that's all they know what to do. That's all they know how to live. And how is that beneficial to them? But again, how is that beneficial to you? You're trying to make something. You're trying to do something. Folks, when I sat down to write my book, I didn't. I had already had 13 different storylines going. And I'd wanted to do it and I wanted to finish it. And you know what? It took somebody with the same growth mindset as me and said, Dave, lay them all out. Figure out the one you're closest to finishing and finish that one. To me, they were all equally the same. But no, I sat down, found out which is the one, and poof, my first book was written. And to this day, I thank my wife for that. Because she said, you know what? Just find the one that you're almost done with, finish it, and then go to the next one. And sure enough, here I am. Now, I'm not a Pulitzer Prize winning. I'm not a New York Times bestseller. I'd like to be a New York Times bestseller. I'd like to win the Pulitzer Prize at least once. Or the Nobel Prize in Literature. Hey, I'd go for that. But you know what? I've done something that 99.99% of the population has not. And that's written a book. Because I said I was going to write a book. And that in itself is an accomplishment. And thank you to everybody that's supported me and pushed me along. But also thank you to those that were negative and naysayers and said, oh, you can't do it. Who does he think he is? Thank you to you too, because you know what? You motivated me just so I could say to myself, I did it. Not to prove anybody wrong. That's a byproduct. That's a nice byproduct. That's to prove the naysayers wrong. But it definitely pushed me to continue to keep going because I knew I could do it. If I had started all of these, I knew I could finish. So that being said, that's why we need to sit down and focus. You need to sit down and focus. I need to sit down and focus. Write down the goals for the next 3 months. Write down the goals for October and November, and then October, November, and December. And then what do you need to finish up for 2019? So go back to January, New Year's Day, New Year's Eve, and figure out what it is that your resolutions were, and figure out which are the ones you can accomplish. You can do it. I can do it. We're going to do it. Let's do it together. I have no problem with that. But the only thing I have a problem with is if we're going to do it, we're going to go all the way. It's just that simple. We got 92 days. So why not? Let's make it happen. So that being said, everyone, thank you for stopping by. Thank you for watching. If you're watching on replay, I appreciate you. Thank you very much. Everyone else, have a great Tuesday evening. And I will talk to you tomorrow. And tomorrow will be early. So be sure to stop by. Until then, have a great one.